As a child, I had a statue of three monkeys inside of my bedroom.
Huh?
Yeah. And I would always stare at that statue deep divers as soon as I would wake up like, what does that really mean? Like the first one was doing this. I can't see. The second monkey was a cheeky monkey, was doing this. I can't hear. And the third monkey was like, I ain't seen nothing, heard nothing. It was like this. And I would always stare at that statue thinking, what on earth does that mean? Then I came to find out it was see no evil, hear no evil, speak no evil. But more than that, it was a symbol of protecting your energy, because there are some energy vampires about. There are forces on this planet who feed off your fear, pain, and sadness. They depend on it for their survival. They are energy vampires. Like when I see everything that's happening on the planet right now, deep divers, truth be told, this is the greatest form of energy vampirism ever known to mankind. Everything that's happening right now on the planet. Therefore, we have to learn how to deal with these cheeky ass energy vampires and say, you ain't gotta go home. Well, you gotta get the hell out of here. We got a whole lot to talk about, deep divers. Peace, infinite waters, diving deep once again. Beautiful deep divers. We are out here in the heart of nature, baby. Another beautiful day. We got birds singing. I'm in a good mood. I'm just, woo, breathing in that good ass prana, baby. Raising the frequency. Raising the vibration, getting rid of those energy vampires. And I'm sending you tons of good ass energy right now. Take that, take that, take that. Energy vampire. Energy vampires. A lot of people right now don't even know that they are in the presence of an energy vampire. A lot of people don't even realize that their energy is being stolen from them every single day from energy vampires. And they come in many forms. In the form of a human being, in the form of a sound vibration, in a form of a company. So energy vampires can take many guises and come in many shapes and sizes. And we have to learn how to deal with them. Because if you don't, you're going to wake up and say, oh my gosh, where did my energy go? Have you ever entered a room, deep divers, all exuberant? You're shining, you got on your new shoes, you're looking so fly. Look at you go. You got your mojo, you got your swag, you got your juice inside of you. You're feeling good about yourself, you're happy, you're radiating this divine energy. But then you stumble across someone. You're in their presence for a few seconds. And all of a sudden, it's starting to mess with your own energy. You don't feel so strong anymore. Like that divine energy you had, is starting to fade away. You're like, oh my gosh, what's happening here? Yeah, you're in the presence of an energy vampire. And you got to do something about that. What are you going to do? Are you going to just stand there? Or do something? And we ain't even had breakfast yet. Can I get a hello there? Now, deep divers, let me share with you what's helped me along my journey. I grew up an intuitive empath, born on March 3rd. I'm a Pisces. What does that mean? It means everybody knows who I am. Everybody like just tells me their problems because they trust me. They tell me these long ass stories of everything that happened to them as a child. I was young. I had 50-year-olds telling me their problems, deep divers. I'm like, what's going on here, right? And growing up, it was hard for me to learn how to protect my energy. Then I realized that because I was always giving, I would give advice and help. A lot of people took that for granted. Right now, with everything happening on the planet, a lot of people are in fear. A lot of people are in doubt. A lot of people feel drained. And that's because their energy has been stolen from them, from an energy vampire. And you have to learn how to protect your energy. You have to learn how to deal with energy vampires, because there are real vampires who drink blood. Oh my gosh. Yeah, I know, right? But there are also energy vampires. And because we are all energy and everything in this earth is energy, energy vampires are not only just human beings, okay? There are also sound vibrations, which are energy vampires. We'll get into that, okay? There are also smells, which are energy vampires, because it's all energy. It's all energy. Now, if you realize you may have met an energy vampire, what is the best thing you can do? I'm talking from personal experience. It starts like this. Many energy vampires can spot easy prey from like a mile away. They know. They can feed off you. They know that they can use you for their survival. Now, a lot of people, ever been around someone, deep divers, who just loves to argue for the sake of arguing? That's an energy vampire. If you know someone in your life right now who's always wanting to start off the conversation with drama, bad energy, shouting at you, hurling abuse at you, that's an energy vampire. And the best thing you can do is say, I'm not accepting that. Return to sender. When someone sends you a letter that you didn't ask for, you can return it back to them. You can refuse the delivery. And that's what you have to do with these energy vampires. You have to learn how to refuse the delivery. Say, actually, no, take it back, Amazon. Because a lot of people, they want to wind you up. A lot of people, they want to work you up. A lot of people want you to argue with them so they can feed off your energy. And we don't need that. We don't need that. We don't need that. So there's a story of a Zen master and an army general. Check this out, deep divers. Real simple. This army general, he was known to intimidate his opponents just by hurling abuse at them. And they would try and get into an argument with him, but they would all lose. Till one day he met a Zen master, and the army general said, oh, look at this old man, this old fool. Let me just hurl abuse at him and call him all kind of names and throw insults at him. The Zen master did not reply to the army general. This confused the army general, until eventually he dropped to his knees and said, forgive me, master. What happened? The Zen master learned one secret, that silence is also an answer. That silence is also a response. Slow motion this side. In other words, he made the army general listen to himself. So the Zen master did not accept the army general's invitation to argue with him. When you learn that, when you take away the food supply of an energy vampire and their food supply is your attention. I repeat, their food supply is your attention. You interacting with them. When you cut that off, they starve to death. Oh, exactly. Energy vampires, the media, one of the biggest energy vampires on the planet. Why? Because they feed off your fear. And they feed off your sadness. You see, a lot of people, they wake up in a great mood, but then they go on social media and they see all of this bad news. Then they feel bad, not realizing they have just been robbed of their energy. So we have to learn that energy vampires are also the government, the media. COVID-19 is going to kill you. Fear, fear, fear. That's the only currency an energy vampire has. What? Slow motion this side. Now, the emotional drive-by is huge. This is how energy vampires operate. Through the emotional drive-by. What they do, they pull up on you. They tell you all of their problems. Then they're like the roadrunner. They scoot off. Oh my gosh. Emotional dumping. If you know someone who does that, you have just been in the presence of an energy vampire. Somebody who pulls up to you and just starts dumping on you all of their problems. Then they just leave. That's how they steal your life force energy. And therefore, you have to set healthy energetic boundaries. Like, I do this for a living, right? I love to help people. I had to learn how to protect my energy. That's why I willingly accept people to tell me what they're going through so I can help them. But if that's not what you're here to do, say, actually, no, no, no. I'm not going to listen to you. I got things to do. You're not going to waste my time, because when they waste your time, they waste your energy. So you have to be very mindful of who you surround yourself with. Every single day, be mindful of who you surround yourself with. Be mindful of who you share your energy with. Only share your energy with people who are going to help nurture it, nourish it, cultivate it. Now, there are energy drainers and there are energy generators. Nature is an energy generator. When I come here, I feel 10 times better when I leave. It gives, it gives. Energy vampires, they take, they don't give you anything. Now, the sun, we all love sitting in front of the sun gazing. We're like energy vampires to the sun, right? We take the energy, right? But if you smile at the sun, you're also giving the sun back energy, okay? You see, everything in life has to be reciprocal. We all naturally take energy every single day. We consume energy, but we also have to learn how to give off good energy so we have balance. Energy vampires, what happens? A lot of human beings have been put into cells, i.e. school systems, i.e. solitary confinement. And what is a cell? A cell is a prison. Now, what are prisons? What is a prism? It's an object that traps light energy, right? So that's what it's all about in this matrix. It's energy harvesting to keep you in a prison or a prism to trap your light energy. And therefore, energy vampirism works like that. You have to learn how to get out of the box. You have to learn how to think outside of the box. Man-made religions, governments, media, these entities were all designed to harvest your energy and to keep you stuck in your five sense reality, to keep you stuck from questioning authority, to keep you a prisoner because they don't want you to be free. Now, when we talk of putting an energy vampire in their place, it's real simple. Focus on you. Don't focus on Trump. Focus on you. Don't focus on the cat down the road. Actually, do that because it's so sweet. Focus on you. Don't focus on COVID-19. Focus on you. Don't focus on fear. I need to wear a face mask every single day and inhale my own toxins. I can't breathe. No, focus on you. Focus on being free every single day. This is how to overcome the grasp of an energy vampire. I want to remind you of this every single day. Energy vampires are always looking for new victims, but many times they pretend to be victims themselves. And many times they come to you with their victim story. They want you to feel pity for them. They want you to feel sorry for them. So the more time you spend with them, the more they steal your energy, the more they finesse you. And we don't need that. We don't need that. We don't need that. So you have to be very polite with the energy vampire and say, no. Learn how to say no and stop feeling guilty for saying it. It could be your boss at work who's stealing your energy. Say no. I don't want to be there. I don't want to subject myself to be in that situation ever again. I'm leaving on a jet plane. I don't know when I'll be back again, deep divers, because I'm in nature just woo, breathing in that good ass prana, baby, getting all the energy I need. Energy vampires. Bad news. That's their secret weapon. You see, deep divers, I said this. I pray for the day when good news is more popular than bad news. Because energy vampires work with bad news. That's what this matrix is full of. COVID-19 cases going up. Be afraid. Be very afraid. Lockdown, this doom and gloom. That's how they steal your energy, by making you feel depressed. So to put an energy vampire in their place, realize life is still beautiful. The earth is still beautiful. Tap into your own world and turn off their world out there. Energy vampires, they come to you with a bad mood. They feel all sad. And sometimes you have sympathy. Sometimes you even have empathy. But that was their plan all along. Ever been around a really moody person, deep divers, and all of a sudden you start feeling moody? Right? That's what energy vampires do. They make you feel like it's you when it's actually them. What's going on here? Jeez! So what you gotta do is you got to know your emotions and what you're feeling and what they're feeling to say, actually, this is me and that's you. If you are off a high frequency, if you are off a high vibration, what happens is that if you meet someone off a low vibration, you have to give them your energy. That's the law of the universe. If you are off a low vibration and you meet someone off a high vibration, you will benefit. You will benefit from them 100%. That's how energy works. So the lower benefits from the higher. The higher doesn't benefit from the lower. So therefore, You want to be around people who complement your own energy. That's how to put an energy vampire in their place. Say, actually, I'm only going to be around people who give me something like I give them something. No free lunch pass. I'm sorry. Energy vampire 7-day vegan challenge. Ever eaten something that looks really tasty? Big barbecue steak. It looks good on the outside, but then you feel sick afterwards. That's an energy vampire right there. Looks can be deceiving. Not everything that glitters is gold, deep divers. Not everything that looks good is actually good for you nutritionally. So when we talk of energy vampires, it can also come in the form of food. Many fast foods are energy vampires. Why? Because they rob you. They rob your body. They have no enzymes in them. Therefore, they rob your body of healthy cells. So we have to realize, what is energy generating? Plant-based foods. That's energy generating. Foods that contain enzymes which actually help you digest the food. Oranges are full of live enzymes. You see, anytime you heat foods over 114 degrees Fahrenheit, what happens? The enzymes get denatured. They lose their nutrients, vitamins. So we have to realize we want to be eating foods full of live enzymes. And that's how to put an energy vampire in its place. I replace the French fries with a beautiful acai bowl, and that's a good to go. Energy vampires. The greatest fear people have. What is that? Many people are afraid to die. Many people are afraid to lose things, right? A lot of people have a lot of fears. But what if I told you fear was the greatest energy vampire in human history? The biggest energy vampire is fear itself. And we have to learn how fear works. Fear works. False evidence appearing real. It gives you an illusion to believe in that something is coming to get you, but it never actually does. It's the anticipation. So realize energy vampires often trick you by telling you that something bad is going to happen, but it never actually does. So you have to be present. You have to lose fear. You have to breathe in that good ass prana, baby, and say there is nothing to be afraid of. What are you consuming? Because whatever you consume will consume you. If you are consuming fear-based media, you are gonna feel bad. But if you are consuming solutions, if you are consuming ways to live in harmony with nature, you are gonna feel fantastic. Energy vampires. Stuck in traffic, that's an energy vampire. Whenever you feel stuck, you're in the presence of an energy vampire. What else? Pollution. Energy vampire. Because it's stealing your energy. Face masks where you can't breathe. Energy vampire. Vaccinations. Energy vampire. Because they are robbing you of your energy. They're changing your DNA, and that's what this is all about, to turn a human being into a human barcode. And you got to say, we ain't having it. No, thank you. I don't need a vaccine. In fact, love is the only vaccine I need. Energy vampires. I want to remind you every single day to realize that some people want to dim your light. Forces. Entities, they know who are the chosen ones, and therefore chosen ones, you have to learn how to protect your energy. You have to learn that energy vampires, they see the light and they want a piece. Even though a lot of them are afraid of sunlight, that's why you got to shine brighter. But their ultimate aim is to dim your light, to dim your shine, to make up stories about you, to take you off course, in other words, to distract you, to take you off your path. That's an energy vampire. If you are around a lot of people right now who are like, hey, let's just drink alcohol all the time, why do you think they call alcohol spirits? Because they are there to possess your soul. Mm. Oh my God. Slow motion this side. Mm. So anytime you have beings or entities around you who are taking you away from yourself, your higher nature, you're in the presence of an energy vampire. So it's up to you to take responsibility to say, actually, I'm only going to be around people who are good for my mental health and my own spiritual evolution. So remind yourself, energy vampires are not only human, they are also sound vibrations. Ever listen to a song and you feel fantastic, full of energy, full of life? You're doing a little samba, baby. But what happens when you listen to a song and you feel terrible afterwards? Because that song was designed to keep you under mind control of hating yourself. That's an energy vampire. See no evil. Hear no evil. Speak no evil. In other words, learn how to protect your senses. Don't just watch everything. Images of violence. Don't just hear everything. Sound frequencies which don't serve you. Don't just speak to anyone who's going to hurl abuse at you. Learn how to protect your energy every single day. And oh my gosh, there are no energy vampires around here because we just drove them away. And that's why I'm just saying, feel so good to be alive, baby. Can I get a hello there? You can't stop the sunshine, baby. So shine brighter. I love all of you deep divers. Let me just, woo, breathing in that good ass prana, baby. Shout out to everybody who's been getting the wonderful good ass prana shirts at ralphsmart.com/clothes and spreadshirt.com. And if you are a sexy ass model, woo, with a whole lot of heart who wants to model the clothing, let me know why you have what it takes. Head to Instagram and go and buy some. Go and buy the clothing, deep divers. Got a question for me? Add me on the verified Instagram page at @OfficialRalphSmart, at Infinite Waters, and Facebook at Ralph Smart, at Infinite Waters. If you want more beautiful information like this to help you evolve and go to the next level, level up, check out the new amazing book for information like this, Feel Alive by Ralph Smart on Amazon and at ralphsmart.com/the book. Deep divers, I love all of you. May your day be free of energy vampires. I love all of you. Peace. Infinite waters, diving deep once again. Stay well, stay healthy. Peace. You! Sometimes you just got to tell an energy vampire, talk to the hand because the face ain't listening.